administration has been accused of crony capitalism in the past. If you recall, the Cash for Clunkers program cost taxpayers $2.85 billion. And then who can forget the $527 million taxpayers lost to Solyndra, the solar panel company that didn't work. But our next guest says now Republicans have a chance to end one bad policy before it's too late. Senator from Utah, Mike Lee, joins us live. Good morning to you, Senator.
Morning, Steve. It's good to be with you.
We've heard a lot about crony capitalism in Washington, D.C. for years now. Tell us a little bit about the Ex-Im Bank. What is it and what is it supposed to do?
This is a bank set up by the federal government that's designed to give special financing options, making those options available to those who buy U.S. products that are sold overseas. Only problem is financing for these products is available on the commercial market. At least it would be if the government weren't getting in the way, if the government weren't in there giving a special sweetheart deal to certain favorites of the federal government.
Sure. And talk about favorites. We got a graphic we're going to put up. In 2012, loan guarantees went out to the tune of almost $15 billion. But here's the thing. $12 billion was for Boeing. Why does Boeing, which is, I think, the world's biggest plane maker, if not Airbus, why do they need billions of dollars to do business overseas?
Well, that's a very good question, and that's exactly the question that I'm asking here. I don't think that the American taxpayer ought to be on the hook for that. I certainly don't think that the American taxpayer ought to be forced against his or her will to do anything that picks one industry or one player within one industry. This is the party. The Republicans in particular are supposed to be the party of the free market economy. That's what we want, is free enterprise.
Sure.
So this is a good opportunity for us to demonstrate that we are that party and that we want to get government out of the business of picking winners and losers.
So what do you want to see happen to the Ex-Im Bank?
Well, I'd like to see it phased out. I'd like to see it ramped down and gradually just have this effort turned over to the private sector where it properly belongs. Financing of large industrial equipment, financing of large airplanes, really ought not be something that the government is involved in. This is something that banks do,
sure,
not governments.
And this is something you've been on this program talking about in the past, where the government should not be in the business of picking winners and losers, particularly if they're giving $12 billion to Boeing, which is already a winner.
Yeah, that's right. That's right. And this is the same sort of thing that we have seen in other contexts. Let's take Solyndra, for example.
Right.
There, the federal government picked a winner, and it turned out to be a loser, and the taxpayers ended up getting hurt. But it's not just the taxpayers that get hurt when something goes bad. It's everyone. It's competitors in the marketplace who, you know, but for this government intrusion, would have a better opportunity to compete.
Well, let's see what happens. We'll see if it's still in business in a year or two or if it's kaput. All right. Senator Mike Lee.